Luckily, the murder had taken place on a Friday, and a stock exchange panic in London could be averted. But it was imperative that the police should get to work energetically on the case and produce results as speedily as possible. That was the view of the Cabinet, conveyed to the Commissioner by the Home Secretary. What they wanted immediately was undeniable proof that it was not a case of suicide. The disappearance of the gun with which Sir Robert had been shot was no doubt sufficient proof, but it was not complete proof. The medical report, the Commissioner had to admit a little ruefully, had been rather disappointing, for it was the view of the Home Office pathologist that there was not sufficient evidence to show that the fatal wound could not have been self-inflicted, as the traces of burning round the hole showed that the gun had been fired at close range. Chief Detective Inspector Beckett had certainly committed a blunder in not having the body photographed in the car, but that could not be helped now. His action in ordering the removal of the body to the mortuary was no doubt justified in the circumstances, but knowing who the murdered man was, he should have at once realised the importance of establishing, beyond doubt, the real cause of death. Still, it was perhaps unfair to blame him for failing fully to appreciate the international repercussions of the murder. There was another ticklish aspect of the crime, and that concerned the suggestion, which had appeared in one of the papers, that the murder might have been committed from political motives. But the Commissioner was very sceptical about it. The special branch would naturally have to look into it. The Assistant Commissioner had already issued all the necessary instructions, and Mooney could be certain that if anything was discovered, he would at once be informed about it. But it was not that way the Communists worked.